Yo guys, welcome again to this amazing training. And just to recap, the last video we talked about out of funnel, and in this video we're going to talk about landing pages. So that's it, let's keep going. If you don't see the landing pages menu, you can create here, like create landing pages, or going on the left up corner, and you will find landing pages. So let's create landing pages. Pretty straight. So as you can see, we have already auto funnels. Basically, auto funnels, with auto funnels, you create many landing pages that incorporate in just one package. Auto funnel basically is a process that all your customers need to go through. With landing pages, it's basically just a simple process. So let's create landing pages. Now we have many templates here to choose from. You need to choose one that is more related to your business. So as you can see, we have many templates here. Let's try with sign up and registration, adding some filters. Let's say we are going to use something like let's use this one for fitness template. You need to write here a name for your own understanding. Put here a name that you won't forget it, okay, to organize well all your landing pages. Let me say this one, we're gonna say subscription. And the thank you page, let's see how beautiful it is. Okay, it's a simple one, that's good. Next step. Now remember that if you watched the last video, almost everything that we're gonna see right now, you saw how we created all those pages, and the process by creating landing pages is not different. Basically it's similar with the with auto funnels, because auto funnels include landing pages as well. So just put that in mind. HTML. All right, the monster is loading your template. The monster is loading my template. Thank you, monster. Okay, now as you can see, you can edit basically every single aspect. This is your logo. If you want to edit this logo, upload new image, and you can edit anything you want. Now remember something, with sign up pages, please don't use too many things, because all these things is gonna be just some kind of distraction to people. Just simplify all the process to increase your opt-in rate. So you can say we don't want name, we just want an email. Let's increase this. Okay, sign up for daily inspiration. Okay, make movement an everyday part of your life. And so you can, let's edit something here. Okay, get it with us, our online trainings. This is some kind of bullet point just to make people understand a little bit more about the business. Instead of this, you can add reviews. So we don't have a review, but you can add reviews. For instance, if you have some famous guys on your town, some people that are famous, or people that people as well know, or people that are known very well, you can ask them for reviews and then put here reviews to all of them. Put your reviews, and it also improve or increase your opt-in rate. And basically we can say that. Now let's talk a little bit about the elements that we can use. With elements, you can add, for instance, if you want to add more section, this is one section. Okay, this is a section. And if you say I want to add more section, you can just grab this and take it to the place that you want to put. Let's say I'm gonna put here. When this blue line is shown up, you put here this section. As you can see, it went down, and you can add more items there. Let's delete this one. If you want also to add, maybe you have a YouTube video or a Vimeo video, you use this element and take it to the place you want to put. Let's do some changes. Just okay, let's do something here. Let's put this a little bit more smaller. Okay, sign up, inspiration. Okay, for instance, let's say we can add more. Okay, we can say we can put this video right here. I know that it's not beautiful, but let's just say we can put this video right here. And this video, you're gonna explain a little bit more about what they're gonna get if they give us the emails. So you can do that. You can also use a button, add a button. And let's say you're gonna put this button here. With the button, you can double click on the button to open all the settings of the button. Now you can change the color of the button. You say, I don't want this color, let me put some other color. Let me put I'm not good with colors, but let me say white. Oh shit, let's leave okay, just for example, it's this one. And I'm gonna say here, for instance, sign up, double click, and then write sign up today. And if you want, for instance, to say this button, I'm gonna open a new website or a new link, or maybe take them to different part of the page, you know, on to highlight the section, you just come here on this anchor that you can see here, and then click here the type. If you say it's a website, then paste here the link. You can say google.com and open a new windows and put a title if you want. Or you can say, no, I'm gonna, this is for phone number, they're gonna call me, or email, or section. When you say section, it means that if they click on this button, it's gonna take them to a specific section of this exact page. Okay, let's say section 1. Section 1 is the part one, the part of the above the first section. Let me just show you first section here, the second section, and the third section. You can add more section. It's gonna be the fourth section. You can add many sections. Now remember, with landing page, please don't add many text, don't add many information, because it's so overwhelming. You know, people wanna look to it and say, oh my god, there's so much information. And when there is many information, if you give to people many information, they will just leave and they won't read. Don't put too much information, please. Yeah, let's say you're gonna open section 1, and that's it. You can edit the page the way you want. Let's delete this page. If you want to preview, click here if you want to preview. Now if you want, in nowadays it's crucial that you also optimize your website or optimize your landing page for mobile. And GetResponse also, they give you the option to optimize for mobile. If you want to optimize for mobile, you see here this icon. Click on the icon. Okay, let's go mobile. And as you can see, you can delete everything as well. Some thing that you don't want to show up on the mobile. And let's say I don't want to show up on the mobile all this information here. I click here and then say hide this, and then I'm going to hide this on the mobile. and I'm going to hide this, and I'm gonna take this a little bit more up. I'm gonna send the mobile. I don't want too many information. Okay, now it's perfect. That's enough. Or you can change that. This video needs to go come first, and the sign up form next. And I'm from next. Yeah, let's do something there. So I didn't form first. Okay, you can edit the way you want it. If you don't want a video, or you don't have a video, you don't necessarily need to put a video here. As you can see, it looks a little bit beautiful. By the way, when you're building these pages, don't waste too much time trying to make it beautiful, because it's not about being beautiful, it's about simplicity. Okay, just make it simple. Create something simple. Simple is better. Simple is better. Oh, let me undo this. Okay, now we got it. So we have this, and as you can see on desktop, we have this video here, and then we have the sign up button here. I don't know why it went down, but it went down. And we can put this here, we can put this. We drag and drop to put it beautiful. You don't need to be perfect with this, okay? Just put this in mind. Let's say we don't want video for our desktop version. Now that's it. You can use many other elements, as you can see, counter timer. You can put the counter timer for, you know, 2 days, and say if it's gonna happen 2 days. If you want for these 2 days, if you don't sign up, they're gonna lose this offer. And elsewhere, you can add variant. As you can see, we have variant A. You can add variant B, make some changes with this variant B, just to see, to test. This is some kind of test A/B, you know, to see which one gonna perform better. And let's delete this one. Now let's go to the next step. Proceed with the mobile version. You can edit the mobile version as well, because we made a change on the desktop version. You need to make the change on the mobile version as well. So the same, as you can see, if you watched the last video, you don't have a problem here, because we talk almost all the time about it, because we build for landing pages. We talk about the SEO settings to say something here. Grab your training. Today, you need to learn a little bit about SEO. You don't need to be an expert on SEO, but it's crucial for your, if you want to index your pages on search engines. Now, confirm the opt-in. No, we don't want that. Add into SQL, we don't want that. We have a list, let's use online course 17, and then publish. Now it's done, your landing page is ready to be used. You can grab this link and keep this link to everybody that you want them to use your landing page. As you can see, we have the landing page. It's not that beautiful because we overwrite this setup here. Okay, it's not that beautiful, but was. Now remember, you can edit anytime this specific landing page that you created. You can go back and see how is it. If it's not good, go back and edit and move, test, change captions, change anything you want that you don't see is resulting well, and send traffic to you to this page for almost 1 month or maybe 1 week. If you see that the opt-in rate is not good, then add some reviews and decrease the test that you see on the page, and maybe just one sign up button and specific test, specific title. And that's it, guys. Thank you. We're gonna see it again on the next video. Thank you.